She made it to the top.
Well, I have the Armani shows. I have the approval of the king of fashion.
But it came with the cost.
I don't think I ever felt good enough. I knew that I had to keep the way that I truly felt under a mask.
How she found a new life on today's 700 Club Interactive.
On 700 Club Interactive, we use technology to pray for each other and explore topics that matter to you. Watch what God is doing in the world today.
Well, good morning and welcome to the show. Every year, thousands of young hopefuls audition for the show America's Next Top Model. They want the fame, the glamour, and the lifestyle of a runway model, no matter the cost.
Jennifer Strickland doesn't dream of being America's Next Top Model because she used to be one. She was discovered young and soon became one of Armani's favorite girls. Jennifer thought she was living the dream. In reality, she was living a silent nightmare.
My diary was my voice. It was the way that I could speak. I had friends that were cheerleaders or prom queens or volleyball players, and I was not that. I just wanted to be like everybody else. I didn't dream about being a model, but it was this place where I was accepted. I knew that I had to keep the way that I truly felt under a mask. I don't think I ever felt good enough. I built my career on TV commercials and catalogs. Then when I graduated from college, I started to do the runway. I spent my whole life to get to that stage. And when I got there, I felt so empty. I looked around at all of the girls behind the scenes. You could see every rib down their backs. You could see their longing to be approved in the way they would lean into the mirror and lean into the camera. And I became so uncomfortable in my own skin, to the point that ultimately that made me sick. And I thought, well, I have the Armani shows. I have the approval of the king of fashion. I'm fine. But I would go home and I would write on the pages of my diary. They were this record of this conversation between my body and my spirit. My body having to be something that it was never going to be, which was perfect, and my spirit saying, I want to be free. Models don't speak. You just wear the outfit and take the picture. But I had this longing to say something. I tried to fill the emptiness with everything our world says is gonna fill it. I'm standing on the stage of Armani Studios, and he notices that the waistline is not hitting me the same. I've gained about 3 or 4 pounds. But he can see it, and he was like, oh, no, no. And my agency was angry with me and disappointed in me, and my job started dropping off, and my career went on a real downhill spiral. I ran. I went to Rome, and it was there in Rome that my backpack was stolen. And I realized that my bright yellow diary was in the backpack. I started to cry. I thought, you know what? I don't even know if God is real. I don't even know if you hear me. I don't know if you see me, but if you do, will you at least save my diary? It was like somebody stole my voice. And I just wanted to know that someone would hear it. One day, I went on a walk in the park, and there were some people handing out Bibles. They barely spoke any English, but they looked into my eyes, and they seemed to care. I started reading that there was this wide road and this narrow road, and the wide road is easy, and everybody's on it, but it leads to destruction. And then there was this narrow road that leads to life. I'm walking down this really wide road one day into the center of Munich. And as I'm walking along, I'm holding my little portfolio, and suddenly this man just stops me in the middle of the road. He was really sort of out of time. And he says to me, you know, where are you going? And I said, well, I'm going to a casting. And he said, my dear, you cannot sell beauty. You cannot sell your face. Turn around. Go to Zugspitz. It's the highest mountain in all of Munich. But then go home. It was like he gave me courage. He said, you're worth more than that. And so I turned around and I took my little Good News Bible and I went to Zugspitz. And I laid down in the snow and I gave my life to Christ. When I went back to my apartment, there was this little brown package on my doorstep. And inside was my yellow diary. Somebody found it 300 miles south of Rome under the seat on a train. I knew that God heard me. And I knew that God had a purpose for me. When I left, I was the caged bird, free. I was gonna find what I was good at. I was gonna have my own dreams. I had so much resentment, and I went through a long period of forgiveness. God has helped me to release my past, and I am not defined by the fact that I was a model. I am defined by my Heavenly Father. I had to lose my value to find it. And I found it in Christ and in the pages of that little Good News Bible where he said, if you're broken, I love you. And if you're lost, I adore you. And if you're possessed, I can free you. And if you're sick, I can heal you. And if you're afraid, like, I'll be your courage and your king.
I'll ask you the same question that was asked Jennifer. Where are you going? So often in life, we think we want the things the world has to offer. We think we want success. You know, for Jennifer, that success was defined, well, I'm a model, I'm Armani's favorite girl. But then when you reach that, and you reach that point, then you find out, well, this really doesn't satisfy what I thought I was going to get, I didn't get. And then the world always makes, well, there's something more, there's something more, there's something more. And you keep looking and striving. And as you climb this ladder of success, you start to realize, well, maybe my ladder is leaning against the wrong building. And I'm not getting the things that I want. It's not satisfying me. I've achieved things, but it doesn't last. It doesn't bring me joy. It certainly doesn't bring me peace. And that's what happened with Jennifer. And at the top, she found out it's actually very cruel there. That a difference of 3 pounds is the difference of raging success and absolute failure. What about you? Where are you going? And do you understand that for all of us, the destination is eternity? And is your mind fixed there? Because if it is, then you know righteousness, peace, and joy. You know that narrow path. You hear his voice and you follow it. But if you don't know, and you're in the broad way, start to realize, and start to realize today, that that way leads to destruction. There's nothing at the end of that road. I don't care how much money you make, how much fame you have, it doesn't satisfy. The only thing that satisfies is the relationship you were made for. And when you understand that, when you understand he has put eternity in your heart, And the only thing that satisfies that is the eternal one. When you realize that, then you found the great secret, the mystery of life, that we were made for a relationship with Him. And without Him, there's no peace, there's no joy. But with Him, there is righteousness, peace, and joy. If you want it, pray the prayer, same prayer that Jennifer prayed. Here she is desperate, she's lost her most treasured item, her diary. And she prays out, God, if you're real, if you hear me, if you know I'm here, could you restore that to me? Well, God answered her prayer. But first He had to show her, and there's something far greater than a diary, far greater than a career, and that is the relationship with Him. So here's your prayer. Jesus, if you're real, if you really want to know me and have a relationship with me, if you really want me to know you, can you show me? And if you pray that with all of your heart, the Bible says that you'll find Him. And when you find Him, you find the answer to every human need. If you want someone to help you with that prayer, we're here for you. And the number's toll free, 888-777-1999. And if there are things weighing you down, if you're wondering, can Jesus forgive that? Can I really be made new again? Well, we're here for you. We're not here to judge you. We're not here to condemn you. We're here to tell you, God loves you, and He made you unique. Among all His creation, He made you unique for a unique relationship with Him. So call us. Number's toll free, 888-777-1999. And if you would like to learn more about Jennifer's story, her book, Girl Perfect, is available nationwide. Terry?
Well, still ahead, her mother was a prostitute, and she was determined to be different until the unthinkable happened.
I was no better than my mother, and it deeply disturbed me because I had become her.
How she was rescued from her mother's fate when we come back.
You're your grandpa named Pop, right?
He died when I was your age.
I saw him in heaven.
What if an ordinary boy?
Is this him?
That's Pop.
Your son had a near-death experience.
Discovered the answer to life's most extraordinary question.
Do you think my son went to heaven?
He told me everything was all right.
Based on the incredible true story.
We all want to be supportive.
I want to believe him.
But everything he talks about is impossible.
Will you believe?
You saw heaven?
It's beautiful.
Heaven is for real. See it this Easter. Rated PG.
I was having some pains between my shoulder blades. At that point, everything changed. Diagnosis, pancreatic cancer.
First, there was prayer. The second is to fight. As soon as we walked through those doors at Cancer Treatment Centers of America, all my anxiety left. The pastoral care here is based on the Bible, based on the Word of God, just as it is at our own church.
When you combine the great medicine with the spiritual resources we have, it provides the patients with something that really can make a difference.
You got a pastor right there on staff praying with patients, and whether it be scripture or whether it just be a word of encouragement to say, God's got this.
If you or someone you love is fighting complex or advanced stage cancer, go to cancercenter.com/faith. You'll learn how our treatment results compare to national averages and see a list of insurance plans with which we've worked. Advanced medicine and technology, the warm embrace of the Spirit.
I firmly believe God led me here.
Call or go to cancercenter.com. Cancer Treatment Centers of America. Care that never quits. Appointments available now.
By the time Sheila was 7 years old, she was taking care of herself and her siblings. She vowed never to follow in her mother's footsteps as a prostitute. But as an adult, she headed in that direction until a voice called her back.
Sheila Ladisaw grew up the daughter of a prostitute in Los Angeles. As the oldest of seven children, the burden of parenting often fell on her young shoulders.
I had no childhood. I remember being on a Saturday, and I wanted to go outside and play. I said, well, I'll just put these basket of clothes here and I'll sneak downstairs. Just for a minute, I'll walk around, you know, get some fresh air and, you know, and I'll come back upstairs. Well, I don't think I was there for maybe 3 minutes when I heard my mom yell my name and I just felt my heart drop. Well, she didn't take it too well. And I paid for it. I paid for it. It was times like that, that it was hard.
When Sheila was 7, her mother had a nervous breakdown. The children went to live with different relatives.
Myself and my oldest brother stayed with my grandma. And I think that was one of the happiest times of my life, actually, because I got to be a little girl then.
Sheila attended Catholic school and learned about God. She vowed her life would be different from her mother's.
I loved getting up and going to church. You know, it was just my time, you know. And if anybody asked me, what are you going to be when you grow up? I'm going to be a nun.
Despite her good intentions, Sheila got pregnant when she was 15. Her mother was not happy.
Her first response was, you know, of course you can't keep it. But I told her, I said, I don't want to get rid of it. I went to the young man and spoke to him. And he said, oh, no, I want this baby. In fact, he gave me a ring. And he said that you're going to keep this baby. He said you're going to finish school. And when you finish school, we're going to get married.
2 months after her daughter was born, Sheila's fiancé got into an argument with someone and was shot and killed. At 16, Sheila felt like her life was over.
I felt lost. I felt like at one point I had some hope. You know, all my hope was just gone. You know, I didn't know what to do.
Sheila's mother tried to convince her to try prostitution, but Sheila resisted. She finished high school, moved out, and married. After the birth of her second baby, Sheila felt her life was falling into place.
I'm finally happy. I'm finally getting the brass ring. You know, I'm finally at a place where I have some peace. I have someone who loves me.
Then one morning after her husband left for his job, Sheila got a phone call.
It was the president of the company. He said, there'd been an accident. So I get to California Hospital, and there he is. I was 21 years old. And I remember, I just fell to my knees, and I said, not again. Not again.
After his death, Sheila was devastated.
I think at that time, I began a downward spiral. Because I couldn't understand why it was snatched away. So I went into a state of depression. And I stayed there. I just stayed there. And I didn't know how to get out of it. And I started relying on medications.
Sheila went from taking painkillers and smoking pot to using cocaine. During the day, she tried to be a good mom. At night, she prostituted herself for drugs.
I was no better than my mother. And it deeply disturbed me because I had become her.
One night, Sheila went to a hotel with a customer. After they arrived, she discovered it was a setup, and Sheila was raped by a gang of 15 men. Physically, emotionally, and spiritually, at the end of her rope, Sheila cried out to God.
I looked up to God and said, you know what, God? I'm hurting, and I don't want to hurt anymore. I'm tired of the life that I'm living. Only person can help me right now is you, God. And that was the first time I ever heard God speak to me. And I heard that voice loud, and it was audible. And he said, I'm here, and it's gonna be okay. And I'll never forget that. I'll never forget it. And that was the first time in my life I felt secure.
Sheila moved in with her grandmother and started going to church.
My whole life changed. I joined a church and God spoke to me. When God calls us, we have to heed.
Today, she's an ordained minister and happily married to Donald.
He's a man after God's heart. We've been able to build a relationship based on the love of God, and that makes a difference.
Sheila is grateful for the new life she has found in Christ.
You know, it's like that butterfly. A butterfly has to go through a metamorphosis. He has to struggle to be able to gain his wings. When we become that new creature, we get our wings because we are that new creature in God. God has built us up from the inside out, just like that butterfly.
Boy, what a journey Sheila went on. I love her analogy about the butterfly. You know, a number of years ago, I bought butterfly larvae for my kids, and we raised them. And it was surprising to me that when they broke out of that cocoon, there was blood on their wings. I mean, it really took effort for them to do that. But the message that I think is so powerful and what she says is what God spoke to her. I'm here. I'm with you. And he is with us through all of the pain, all of the heartache, all of the metamorphosis of becoming that life sometimes puts us through. He uses it all. Well, this is 700 Club Interactive, and we want to be praying for you wherever you're at in your life right now. We have a request that's come in from Andrea, who says, my daughter is a people pleaser, and she's also insecure. I see that she struggles with self-esteem and her self-worth. I worry that she'll find her value and worth in men and become promiscuous. Please pray that God will protect her.
Then we've got one from Tyler who says, please pray for my family. My older sister passed away 5 years ago from a drug overdose. She was only 19 when she died. My younger sister is now out of control and doing drugs. She says that she's smarter and won't overdose. I'm scared for her, and I don't want to lose another sister. I don't know what to do. Please pray that God will become real to her and change her life. Tyler, you need to tell your younger sister, your older sister didn't make a mistake. It wasn't something, overdose is not something that stupid people do. Overdose is a regular part of drug addiction, where you think you know the dosage and you don't. So we should actually get overdose out of the language of what we do and say it's the drug that killed her, not the overdose that killed her. It's the drug that killed her. And it's so hard for us to, I mean, you're dealing with street drugs. It's not like this is something that people carefully measure out. Let's pray. Let's pray for people. And if you're going through hard times, take that same word from Jesus. He's with you. He's with you. And he's able to make everything okay if you're willing. If you want to run away, if you want to do your own thing, if you want to hide from God, okay. He'll let you do that. He's a gentleman. But if you want to turn around and turn your life over to him, where it's not your will anymore, it's his will, then the change comes. And then everything will work together for your good. He's able to take the nightmare and make it a dream if you just let him. So let's pray. You pray, we'll pray for these people, these families, and we'll just believe God for you. Join with us. Lord, we lift the needs of the audience to you right now. We just speak over them peace, the peace that passes all understanding. And we ask that you would give them the blessing of hearing your voice,
yes,
of seeing your face. So lift up your countenance upon them and give them your peace, not what the world gives, but what you give, your peace. And now for these troubled hearts, for those who are using drugs, for those who have self-image based on the world's view and not your view, Lord, turn their hearts, give them a glimpse of how much you value them. For we ask it in Jesus' name. Amen. And amen. If you need prayer, give us a call. We're here for you 24 hours a day. Numbers toll free. 888-777-1999. Terry?
Well, still ahead, two young brothers who were begging for food on the side of the road after being abandoned by their parents. Find out how they got a meal and a new life. That's coming up.
I'm Professor Radisson.
Fill in the papers I've just given you with three little words. God is dead.
I can't do what you want. I'm a Christian.
Now.
What do you say to people who don't believe?
We disown him, he'll disown us.
When your faith is tested.
We're going to put God on trial.
Fight for what you believe.
God's not dead.
Science supports his existence. You know the truth. Why do you hate God?
God's Not Dead, rated PG. Now playing.
If you're living with diabetes and have Medicare or private insurance, here is some great news. Call United States Medical Supply today, and we'll send you the smallest glucose meter in the world, absolutely free. So small, it fits right on the bottle of strips.
It only takes a speck of blood, and it gives me my results in 5 seconds. I can even test it on my arm.
And there's no coding for easier, more accurate results.
And if you call now, we'll also send you this stylish, full-featured meter at no charge. That's two free meters. You can keep one in your pocket and leave the other one at home.
You can even hook it up to your computer so your doctor can track your results.
United States Medical Supply also delivers prescription medication right to my door, so I don't have to go to the drugstore anymore.
Don't let diabetes get in the way of living. Give us a call today at United States Medical Supply and get the smallest meter in the world for free. Call today.
You had your grandpa named Pop, right?
They died when I was your age.
I saw him in heaven.
What if an ordinary boy...
Is this him?
That's Pop.
Your son had a near-death experience.
Discovered the answer to life's most extraordinary question.
Do you think my son went to heaven?
He told me everything was all right.
Based on the incredible true story...
We all want to be supportive.
I want to believe him. But everything he talks about, is it possible?
Will you believe?
You saw heaven?
It's beautiful.
Heaven is for real. See it this Easter. Rated PG.
Every day, CBN's Orphans Promise provides safe homes for thousands of children around the world, like these two brothers from Vietnam. At the ages of just 4 and 1, they were starving on the street.
Loam was 4 years old and Vaughn was 1 when their parents abandoned them near their home in Vietnam.
We were so hungry. I carried my brother to my aunt's house to ask for food, but she didn't let us in.
The brothers sat next to the street, hoping that someone would see them and help them.
Vaughn was crying so hard because he was starving. I couldn't do anything to help him.
Another aunt found them and took them in, but over time, she wasn't able to provide for them either.
There was a time when we didn't have food to eat for 2 days. My stomach hurt a lot.
Eventually, the brothers came to live here at this Christian home supported by CBN's Orphans Promise.
The food here is so good, and we get to eat 3 times a day. On our first day here, they also gave us clothes and new towel.
In addition to food and shelter, the boys are also experiencing love. Today, Loam and Vaughn are healthy and active boys. They both do well in school and enjoy playing with their friends.
I want to thank the people who care for us and help us. Come on, CBN.
A safe place to live, food on the table, and an education that gives them hope for tomorrow, as well as the knowledge of God's great love. If you want to be a part of what Orphans Promise is doing around the world, you can do that right now by giving your gift and calling 1-888-777-1999, or you can log on to cbn.com and give that way. We thank you. Gordon?
We leave you this word from Ephesians chapter 5. For once you were full of darkness, but now you have light from the Lord. So live as people of the light. For Terry, for me, for all of us, God bless you. May you have a wonderful day.